From his office in the Pentagon, Air Force Chief of Staff General Lew Allen, Jr.
General Allen, housing, medical care, and other people-oriented programs are a vital concern to all of us. How do we in the Air Force now stand on these quality of life issue areas?
Well, there's no question that we have been able to make a number of very significant improvements. And we have planned and programmed and budgeted for still more improvements as the future comes. Our budget is under fairly strict examination now, and we may not be able to make all of the improvements quite as rapidly as we had wished, but I'm very confident and very pleased that we're making a good deal of progress and we're making it rapidly.
Civilization looking glass aircraft at this time.
Affirmative. Also, be advised. Aircrew is in route.
Well, thank you, Alex.
It looks like just another KC-135 being pre-flighted at Offutt Air Force Base. But it's much, much more. This is an EC-135 belonging to the 55th Strategic Reconnaissance Wing. Captain Tom Anderson explained.
Up front, the EC-135 aircraft looks like just about any other C-135 series aircraft in the Air Force inventory. The big difference is in the back. This is the SAC Airborne Command Post, known as the Looking Glass. The Airborne Command Post is a scaled-down version of SAC's primary underground command post and has the same basic capabilities. On a day-to-day basis, the underground command post controls SAC's forces around the world, but it would be a primary target for a potential enemy during wartime. If the underground command post is disabled, control of SAC's forces passes to the airborne command post. Its battle staff is trained to manage any counterattack the president may direct and to direct the recovery of returning bomber and tanker forces. There is an airborne command post flying over the Midwest 24 hours a day. Additionally, the Looking Glass aircraft has the capability to launch the Minuteman missile force if primary launch control centers are disabled.
Off.
Communications is the key element in maintaining command and control of the forces. Looking Glass is equipped with radios covering a wide spectrum of frequencies and includes the Air Force satellite communications system. At the touch of a button, the battle staff can talk to any SAC base around the globe. When the missile launch codes are loaded and the communications equipment has been fully checked out, the Airborne Emergency Actions Officer will arrive and take command of the battle staff. He is a SAC General Officer trained to take over as Commander-in-Chief of SAC should that become necessary.
The briefing items for you. No significant events. Evaluations, we have the ORI at Minot, both the bomb wing and the missile wing. The weather looks...
Co-pilot. Battery switch.
Emergency.
Triple ground.
Ground pilot, clear on three.
Time to search for 4.5 number 3, fire ground position.
Turning 3.
Lights out.
Everything is basically quiet right now. Captain Henderson is on the KY-3 with the underground.
A lot has changed since the first Looking Glass mission. Major General Lewis Buckman, SAC Deputy Chief of Staff for Operations, flew one of the first missions as a new aircraft commander.
There's been one change to the SAC warning indicators. They've uncovered the naval threat due to an exercise going on in the South China Sea.
Okay, well, keep me updated on that, would you, sir?
There's certainly been a lot of changes in the Looking Glass as far as the equipment and the performance of the aircraft over the past 21 years. But the basic mission to provide a survival command and control element has not changed. I think the great achievement is that it's been airborne continuously for 21 years, and that's due to a lot of dedicated people. We have outstanding air crews, battle staff, but mainly the people who supported on the ground have allowed this to happen. The banner of the maintenance people. They have to be out here 24 hours a day to ensure that we maintain this record and we can meet our commitments.
Every 8 hours, another EC-135 rolls out to take up station as the SAC Airborne Command Post. Round-the-clock readiness. Command and control backup. Making an enemy think twice about striking first. That's the Looking Glass mission.
I'm convinced we are entering a dangerous decade, and therefore we put our emphasis on readiness and sustainability and war reserve materials and additional production of aircraft and weapons that we have great confidence in. So we will move to improve our warfighting capability very quickly, because by being strong, the Air Force can best make its contribution to the continued peace of our country.
Air Force family life offers challenges and rewards that you won't find in civilian life. Family support centers are opening to meet the ever-changing and special needs of Air Force families. These centers provide many services to the Air Force family, everything from financial and premarital counseling to family enrichment programs and support during duty separations.
I'm Chief Ken McLeod. I'm the Senior Enlisted Advisor here at the 347th Tank Fighter Wing, and I deal very closely with the people who run this Family Support Center.
Improving the quality of life for all the Air Force family is the mission of the Family Support Center program.